Welcome back to The Breakfast on PLUS TV Africa. We head straight to our second conversation. We're going to Anambra State to talk about the supplementary elections for Ihiala local government with 148,000 voters. And we do have Dr. Mefor, Law Mefor, on standby this morning. Thank you for joining us, Dr. Law Mefor.
Thank you for hosting me. Good morning, Nigerians.
Morning.
All right, so let's just head straight to the conversation for the want of time. What is going on right now in Anambra State? What does it look like? Are the people willing to come out to vote for the supplementary election? We're talking about Ihiala at this point.
Yes, I believe there is no reason the people wouldn't want to come out. And you recall the reason they couldn't vote on Saturday was because of insufficient manpower. INEC was not able to effectively mobilize to Ihiala, so they felt it was best to defy it. And I agree with them. And the election has been concluded in virtually 20 local government areas. That's enough confidence building for Ihiala people. And they have received assurances from the Anambra State government, from the security chiefs, that there will be maximum security there for them to cast their votes without any form of intimidation, harassment, and all that. So I believe Ihiala will come out to vote and vote massively. I expect even a higher turnout in Ihiala than happened in other local government areas, where people weren't quite sure of the situation of things. Their own case is quite different because they have memory to fall back on. What has happened in other local government areas should bolster their confidence and reassure them that they can vote and that their votes will count.
Okay, let's talk also about the possibilities of upturning what the the figures are looking like right now. APGA has a very large gap between itself and the PDP, which is currently second. Is there any hope that Ihiala might be a miracle for either the PDP or the APC?
Well, for that to happen, you expect that 40 to 50% of Ihiala registered voters have to vote. That means we are looking at 70 to 100,000 voters turning out of the 148. In the history of elections in Anambra State since the return of the country to the present democratic dispensation, Anambra has never recorded even 35%. And if you also go by what has happened in this particular election in the other 20 local government areas where the election has virtually been completed, the voter turnout is not more than 10%. If you want to double it for Ihiala, you are still talking about less than 30% less than 30,000 voters. And APGA already has 52,000 votes, in lead. The implication of that is that for you to really upturn, you need to score more than that number. And of course, stopping APGA from gaining additional votes in Ihiala, which is practically impossible. It's going to be tough. It's an uphill task. It's not impossible, though, because if you actually understand why Ihiala vote is necessary, it's because according to the constitution and other extant regulations, where the margin of win is smaller than the registered number of voters in areas where voting couldn't take place, then you need to do a supplementary election or a runoff to enable you bring them into the picture. because it is assumed by the Constitution that if the 148,000 would all vote and all vote against the winner, or the winning party, and in favor of the runner-up or even another person, it's hypothetically going to obtain the result. But it's only hypothesis. For me, I will, because of the comfortable margin, if it's something like the number of votes is less than 20,000, maybe one will be thinking of the possibility. But the margin is huge. And the turnout in this election has not been quite impressive, even though the circumstances leading up to the election comparatively, make everybody to give the turnout even a pass mark, if not an excellent mark. But the figures statistically appear too huge to be upturned at this stage. It's only one local government.
Okay, let's also share your thoughts on this. Do you think there are other factors that could impede the 148,000 voters? Are there other factors that could impede them from casting their vote?
The factors that would impede them, for me, they don't seem to exist now. For example, the issue of insecurity. Security officials in this election, they have been rather very professional, good, really good. And I don't see them changing that professionalism in any other. It will mess up the record they have already created. Then the threat of sit at home and no government, all that, have not quite played out in this election, not in the last 2, 3, 4 days. We don't expect that to happen. And if it would, because the election should be getting set for now, the evidence should be on ground that there is a breakdown of the law and order in Ighala, and people are now being threatened, but it's not happening. So I think the conditions are quite rife for very peaceful election to make it the icing on the cake of this rather commendable election in Anambra State. And like I said, I commend Anambrians, I commend the security operatives, I commend even IPOB, I commend them also for agreeing to move the city.
But there's also a case, we also have reports that Beavers didn't function properly, and a lot of persons were unable to cast their votes, during the last elections that were conducted.
That's
the issue
correct.
Of network. So, don't you see that as a problem?
The Beavers that worked in last Saturday election will be moved to Ihiala. I don't see Beavers being a problem here now. I believe that the functioning ones now will be decoded and used for the election.
How about the network?
The network. You see, let me tell you what happened with Beavers in the Anambra State. The network providers are not equally strong in all parts of Anambra State. In some places, it's MTN that is pretty strong. In some places, it is Airtel. Or grow and so on and so forth. So the prevalent network in Ihiala, if it is MTN, I expect INEC to configure to MTN to get excellent result. That's what I expect. In fact, if Beavers poses a problem today in Ihiala, it means that INEC needs to really go back to the drawing board. Because I believe that the reason they had problems with the Beavers would have to do with network. That's what I believe. And I read somewhere, I don't know how authentic that is, that Beavers would function optimally with a 4G network. In Anambra, it's 3G that is prevalent, and in many places, less than 3G. I believe that if they should know the network that would suit Ihiala best and deploy the network, reconfigure to that network to be able to get an excellent result.
All right, Dr. Mefo, finally.
What I'm trying to say is that Beavers can pose only very minimal, challenge because INEC had 3 days to really correct that in the year.
All right. Hopefully that is sorted. But I want you to, you know, finally, I think if you can do this in a minute, please, respond to some of the claims by the PDP candidate, Valentine Ozigbo, who was on social media late yesterday, making very, very strong complaints, you know, mostly about the electoral process. He spoke about INEC and its ad hoc staff that were poorly trained. He spoke also about their logistical challenges heavily marring the process. He also went on to say the election was not held in many polling units. Election materials arrived late in some. Coalition and returning officers were forced to sign result sheets, and in some cases, the result sheets were totally fabricated. He also went on to say that the impunity did not begin on Saturday. It takes root from the process in which leaders emerged. The voices of the greater majority of the people were not heard, and the consequences are that they did not get the opportunity to choose who would lead them for the next 4 years. He says agents of two ruling parties at the center and at state level embarked on brazen voter intimidation and vote buying, and some other things that he mentioned. These are his concerns.
I read that also. You see, three things here. One, poor training, poor mobilization, late start, and all that didn't affect only PDP alone. That is one. Then, yes, I agree. I saw pockets of vote buying, but I also saw pockets of where vote buying was actually repudiated by the locals. They refused to take money. I saw that also. I can forward some of the videos to you.
I think I saw and that then, also.
Yes, you know, so we offered money and they said no. And let me also tell you, the issue of vote buying was across. It's not just the ruling party, even PDP was equally involved. That's the truth. You know, the vote buying in Anambra State is a regular practice. That's a fact. That is not right, it's criminal, but it's there. That's the truth. You know, and I also agree with him that the poor performance of Beavers disenfranchised a lot of people. That's a fact. But again, he did not single out PDP supporters. You know, he affected everybody across board. Now, the onus of proof of how this affected him as a candidate is on him, the proof. And then, it's a tough one, because how do you now prove that the poor network affected only areas where PDP members are voting? You know, it is difficult. All his observations actually show, you know, that the exercise was not, perfect. I agree. But you see, the circumstances did not allow a better outcome. There was so much threat, security threat, before the election. So even INEC may not have had the opportunity to do a test run, because what INEC ought to have done was to deploy, what you call a mock election, quietly in Anambra to identify, which network should be stronger and other. Yeah. INEC, I'm not sure, had the opportunity to do that. I'm not making any excuses for them, but you and I know that at a point, we were not even sure the election would go.
Yeah.
So I think we have to give allowance for some of these things. I understand the problem, the anger of Ebalo Zigbo. He was full of optimism. But they cannot also claim that what happened affected only him, or that he is more popular than those who are ahead of him in this election.
Dr. Mefo, we'll have to wrap up here in the interest of time. We're completely out of time for this conversation. But of course, we'll be following up with how today turns out. We have from now till 4 p.m. for the supplementary elections. And we very likely would love to speak with you again. Thank you very much. And we wish you a very beautiful Tuesday ahead. All right. And this is where we say goodbye on the program this morning. If you missed out, remember where to catch up. It's simply at Plus TV Africa on Facebook and Instagram. Same with our YouTube channel, Plus TV Africa. I am Osaogie Ogbonwa.
And I am Mercy Boko. Do have a great day.
Anambra governorship election is not yet over, as Professor Charles Soludo, Valentine Ozibo and Senator Andy Uba and others get ready for supplementary elections in Ihiala local government area of the state today from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m.